are carnivores, and there are herbivores. When comparing these two groups, you can see herbivores are bigger. Actually, some herbivores are so strong that even the strongest predators barely challenge. But to our common sense, carnivores should be stronger and bigger because they should kill other animals to survive. There must be some reasons for this. Well, let's look into how big size can be advantages for herbivores, not carnivores, and from where they get those muscles. We used to imagine herbivore animals as weak and gentle, as they are prey for carnivore animals. The fact carnivores hunt herbivores make us imagine them as strong, brutal, large in size, and muscular. But now the perception about them must change. Herbivores are not that weak, or sometimes they are much stronger than carnivores, especially hippos. They are not just gentle cute animals living near water, they are so wild and violent. They grow up to 1200 kilograms and run as fast as 50 kilometers per hour, and their canines as long as 60 centimeters. Their skin is so tough that it's hard for even lion teeth to penetrate. Hippos are known as one of the animals with the strongest first bite. It's almost 1,000 kilograms, and it makes hippos break human skulls like lollipops. Hippos are one of the most aggressive. If they encounter with intruders into their territory, they chase them to death. Due to their brutality, Egyptians imagine one part body with Amut with hippo, the monster of hell from Egyptian mythology. When it comes to elephants, no animals are matched for them. They are the biggest land animal, 8 meters in length, 4 meters in height, weighing 8 tons, beating 140 kilograms of plants a day. They are so strong that nobody ever dares to challenge. How and why could herbivores have an overwhelming physical? Comparing big carnivores and herbivores, herbivores overwhelm, and there are some reasons. Carnivores, contrary to what is known about them, scavenge for meat often, not hunt. Let's take examples of Maasai lions of savannah. Lions grow up to about 200 kilograms and 185 centimeters in length, including their tail. Their maximum speed is about 80 kilometers per hour, and they can run at that speed for 10 seconds. Their prey run as fast as lions do. Gazelles run 97 kilometers per hour. Zebras 64 kilometers per hour. Giraffe 60 kilometers per hour. Some of prey may look slower than lions, but they can reach a maximum speed very quickly, and they resist so hard. Therefore, lions mostly sneak to prey 15 meters away and ambush them, usually at night. And they can only succeed in hunt only once or twice a week. It means hunt success rate is around 30% to 50%. So they willingly take chance to eat already dead bodies. Even if they hunt for fresh meats, they target young and weak. And if they get bigger in size, they need to hunt and need more meats. But bigger size makes them less agile and makes it difficult for them to hunt small prey. If so, they have to hunt bigger, such as hippos, giraffe, and so on. Hunting of slightly bigger animals consumes up to twice more energy. Also, they have to risk their life hunting big animals with much lower success rate, and more energy is wasted, even when they are doing nothing. Taking these factors into consideration, carnivores over 1,000 kilograms might not survive well. In reality, polar bears, the largest land carnivores, grow just less than 1,100 kilograms. And for the same reason, carnivores dinosaurs could match the size of herbivores dinosaurs. Now for herbivores, bigger size is good for them, because the bigger, the harder to be hunted. And they just wander around to feed on plants, which do not run away from them. So they don't need to be as nimble and fast as carnivores. Though, they can just grow without limit. Because unlike carnivores, which can survive up to 3 days with one satisfying hunt, they need to engage in day-long travel for incredible amount of plants. There's one exception. Marine carnivores can grow much bigger because gravitational limit is less, and bigger volume is good at keeping body temperature underwater. For example, blue whales are the biggest carnivore of all kinds of animals. Blue whales must be able to increase their size because they feed on zooplankton. Tons of zooplankton gather in one place and simply do not move that much. so blue whales feed zooplankton like herbivores as they please. Anyway, how do herbivores grow muscular and big only eating plants? Would vegetarianism make us big as it does to herbivores? No, it didn't. Mild and peaceful image of herbivores come from the fact that the plants contain less calories, fat, and protein compared to meats. But herbivores overcame by eating tons of them. There are animals with more than one stomach. Cows, sheep, deer, giraffe, which are called ruminants, have four stomachs, and they can extract nutrition from plants as much as possible. Let's take an example of cows. Cows are living fermentation tanks. The most of nutrition that cows get are not from what they eat, but from microbes in their stomach. Cows chew grasses not for hunger, but for growing microbes. In the first and second stomach, microbes dismantle and ferment plants into sugar, amino acids, fatty acids, vitamins, and so on. Microbes feed on sugar, and other nutrients get absorbed in the third stomach. The first stomach is the graveyard of countless numbers of microbes. Dead microbes go through breakdown process with digestive fluid into amino acids, that is, protein. And other nutrients microbes produced also get absorbed. Microbes are composed of 40 to 60% of proteins, and there are 1,000 trillions of them in the stomach, weighing 10 to 20 kilograms. So cows can get just enough protein in this way. For those animals like elephants and rabbits with only one stomach, large intestine and cecum go through a similar process, but not as efficient. Rabbits save nutrients in cecal walls they discharge through anus, and they eat them again to fully absorb remaining nutrition. There are 100 million microbes in a gram, so it is very rich in protein. Elephants have one big stomach, but because it can only digest 40% of food, they have to eat a lot. Some other animals just heavily rely on protein-rich grains and fruits. Then, how about fat? Cellular walls of plants are composed of cellulose, which is dietary fiber. It is so tough that human stomach cannot simply digest them. These dietary fiber are mostly carbohydrates, which can be transferred into sugar, which microbes change into fat. So, we don't have to be worried if vegetarian diet may make us fat, because we don't have enough ability to digest plants into protein and fat. Also, we don't grow trillions of protein-producing microbes in our stomach.